I saw one, but it was old and abused at the time.
Yeah, that's the way. That's the same thing as that Red Hot Chili Pepper song. Give it away. But no, when you say that game, they cringe, and the next words out of their mouth is the worst video game ever produced in mankind.
Huh.
And I sat back and I said, well, I don't think so. They were worse. And it's credited for that because a lot of people don't know this. And if you want to watch a good show, they have the story of this on Netflix. The story of E.T. and how it did not crash Atari. A lot of people think because of that crappy game that they produced, and as quickly as the guy produced it, by the way, which was record-breaking for any video game, he had to have it done in like 5 weeks.
Right, now, E.T., now this was a video game based on the Spielberg movie.
Right, and he had 5 weeks to get this sucker done and ready to be in the kids' Christmas stocking before Santa Claus got there. And he did it. And the game was difficult.
It had Spielberg's blessing, though, because they had to get his approval before they launched it.
Let me give you a little word. Spielberg isn't always in his right mind.
Look at some of his movies.
Let's just say that. I'm not going to say he does drugs or drinks, but he's not always in his right mind.
But they had to produce a game to satisfy the man funding it.
And
he's
did.
Like, this is my thing. This is my movie. If you're going to turn it into a video game, I better like it.
And he did. Yep, he did. And no Atari did. Crashed soon after that. And they blame that game. But the reality of it is Atari was one of those companies where partying was on the top priority list. Where the player or the game designers will even mention the fact that recreational party drugs was part of an everyday clock in and clock out situation.
Now let's just stick up for recreational party drugs here for a second. Why? Doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be the demise of a company.
Well, it is when the stuff costs what it does cost, and you're doing it
every day. If I think back to the Atari days, what happened to Atari wasn't so much the cost of the recreational drugs. The problem with Atari was that they were too busy using the recreational drugs to maintain their cutting edge in the video game industry. So I think that, you know, and E.T., the game, was an example of not maintaining the cutting edge. It was kind of like looking at one of the symptoms of the underlying disease. I think that's what happened to Atari. They just let the competition jump right ahead of them.
Now, the other thing with Atari is everybody thinks that it was only E.T. that they disposed of. There is a site, and it's in New Mexico. All the games are already dug up, so they don't try to go out there and find them. They dug them up April 26, 2014. Say the name of the town again, because I really can't.
I'm not looking at it, so I can't pronounce it.
Alamogordo?
Sounds good. They buried them all in there, and they had to go through this huge trial to get to be able to dig these out because there was all sorts of waste and dead animals buried on top of this.
Well, and there's also some radioactive men in black buried on top of them,
right,
too.
Yeah. So they had to go through all these steps and doors just to be able to find, never mind find where these were, but to dig them up.
Now they were digging them up for what reason? To hammer a stake through the game so it would never rise again?
No, to prove that they buried them. Because it was considered one of those urban myths that they didn't do this. They never buried this. And this guy was like, yes, they did. I worked in the dump when they buried him. I saw the truck come in and unload him. And I stuck to his words. A couple years later, after retiring, they dug him up. And nerds from all around the United States stood in this huge line.
In the heat. In a sandstorm.
With the smell of that trash being pulled up out of the ground, because you know that did not smell well. Decomposing trash,
30-year-old trash.
Not so good. Just to get the E.T. video game. And to their surprise, it wasn't just the E.T. video game that was buried. there was about 7 or 8 different Atari games, brand new, buried in the package.
Now, were these games that were never released?
No, they were released, and they were popular. They were just an overabundance of them, and they buried them instead of selling
them. Buried the overstock, basically.
Yeah, literally. And that's, we can't sell this, let's gonna hide it.
Now these stupid games are up on eBay, and these nerds are selling these things for $4,000 to $6,000 a piece. And I remember paying a flippin' nickel for some of these games at Rocky Hill Flea Market.
Now, the tone of Chuckles' voice tells me that he's really pissed off at missing the boat on this one.
Yeah.
Because we weren't down there at the Almagoro trash site.
I actually am.
Owned by the city. The city owns the games and has them locked up. Atari has no claim to it. So the city is the ones that sold them off originally and still is hiding them and harboring
them. Yeah, they have a freaking storage unit full of these trash video games, and they're selling them. And there was even one kid that showed him, he blew the thing off, put it in the system.
It worked.
It started right up. No flipping issues. Now, if you were to take a DVD or a CD and you do that to that,
well, yeah, that's
done.
Atari games with a Model T Ford of video.
I spent countless hours. I know you did. Nurse Misery, not so much. Tony Jones did. Countless hours playing some of these Atari games, and there were no ends to most of these.
You played until you died.
Yeah, until your eyes were going cross-eyed. You had the googly eye.
Figuratively and literally.
Yeah, I mean, these games had no ending. Pac-Man just got harder and harder and harder. I mean, Asteroid, there was no ending to these games, but we wasted our life in front of these things. And they were fun. So when they died out, it was kind of sad, but you see that they're coming back in a large way, retro gaming. They're selling the packages and everything. And
those retro and everything.
They're starting to bloom up and just get just as popular as some of the modern game systems.
Aren't there a couple of Atari games, while we're on the subject of buried games and at the end of Atari's life, weren't there I cannot remember for the life of me the names of them, but weren't there a couple of games that they almost never saw the light of day? Maybe like a handful of copies were released. Nobody bought them, or a handful of copies were released, and then they buried them.
Aren't there a couple of those semi-legendary? A couple that Activision didn't release towards the end, and then they released it on a compilation disc that came out for PlayStation 2. I'm pretty sure there was like 5 of them. I can't remember the name of them off the top of my head. We'll have Nurse Misery look that up while we go to break. But while we're going to a little music here, we're going to listen to some Bloodhound Gang. Only here on Chuckles Crypt do we play something other than the Discovery Channel song. Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio's Bloodhound Gang.
Baby. We'll be right back.
little Bloodhound Gang there for you. Nurse Misery, what's the name of that title again? Because guys saying this, it just doesn't sound right. Go ahead, tell them the name of that song.
You're really going to make me do this again. Do it because again. Last time I was only allowed on the show basically to say this name.
And if you don't say it, you're not allowed on the show again.
Ooh, it's my out. No. It's Unce, Unce, Unce. Even though I'm not putting the proper enunciation into that because it's going to sound a little disturbing.
It is.
So this is as little effort and as unawkwardly as possible I could say that title.
And as much as you guys think out there that those trophies that you get on the video game systems are going to get you to hear those noises, this is the closest thing you're going to get, Bowdy. So record that and play it in the back of your head.
If you hear it as pitifully as I said it, she's faking.
Well, if they even hear that, if they get away from their parents' basement, so who cares if they're faking at that point? Now, we searched the internet quite rigorously lately, trying to find a top 10 list, and all the same games kept coming up for every time we hit this.
Oh, the number one never changed.
No, it doesn't change.
Like, 2 through 10 had some wiggle room.
And I got to look at some of these, and a lot of these games, I go, what are they? I've never played them.
Like, so you're talking top 10 games
of all time.
Of all time.
Yeah, and I'm like, either I'm really not popular, or, again, the guy that made this list is the same guy that made the last list we didn't like for top 10 Avengers.
Avenger villains, right?
Yes.
That's the one we really hated.
Yeah, that guy was an idiot. So, here comes hate mail number 55. How dare you call me an idiot?
Well, don't forget, you're calling the person an idiot who has paid an unlawful amount of money to Google and Facebook to get his preferences, you know, in that blind auction, raised to the top.
He's still an idiot. So
that's why I'm just emphasizing what an idiot he is.
Let's go down to top 10. We'll do it really quick. Or that's the way I like it. Really quick and silent. GoldenEye 007, 1997. Now, if you guys remember this game, I do remember this a little bit. I believe it was Nintendo 64.
Yeah, it's, I remember it. I don't know. I don't remember it making a fuss, though.
First-person shooter. The two-player part to it was actually pretty cool. One thing I remember being able to do is shoot the dude through the bathroom while he's sitting on the toilet, and I thought that was great fun. Number 9, Resident Evil 4. Never played it. Never really got into the Resident Evil series, although they said you didn't have to play this one.